वेलकम टू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल मैथमेटिक्स विद सचिन एंड दिस इज लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन रिप्लेसमेंट प्रॉब्लम एंड दिस इज नाइन्थ लेक्चर ऑन रिप्लेसमेंट प्रॉब्लम। इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस ग्रुप रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ द आइटम्स दैट फेल्स कंप्लीटली and examples on group replacement of the items that fails completely. Group replacement of items that fails completely. Sometimes a system contains a large number of identical low-cost items that are increasingly liable to failure with age. Since the value of the item is so small that the cost of keeping records of the individual ages cannot be justified. In such cases, the group replacement is used. Group replacement is concerned with those items that either work or fails completely. For example, electric bulbs. A group replacement policy consists of two steps. Firstly, it consists of individual replacement at the time of failure of any atom in the system, and there is group replacement of existing live units at some suitable time. Here, the individual replacement at the time of failure ensures running of the system, whereas group replacement after some time interval will reduce the probability of failure of the system. The application of such type of policy has to take into the consideration the following points. First, the rate of individual replacement during the period and the total cost incurred due to individual and group replacement during the period chosen. This policy favors the group replacement when the total cost is minimum and the period of replacement is known as optimal period of replacement. The information required to formulate this policy is first, probability of failure, second, losses due to these failures, third, cost of individual replacement, and fourth, cost of group replacement. The classical example of this policy is the replacing the light bulbs. Group replacement policy is defined as one should group replace at the end of tth period if the cost of individual replacement for tth period is greater than the average cost per period through the end of the tth period. Second, one should not group replace at the end of tth period if the cost of individual replacement at the end of t minus 1th period is less than the average cost per period through the end of the tth period. Now, this group replacement policy can be mathematically stated as: prove that C1nt is greater than Ct upon t in usual notations for group replacement policy when t is its optimal time interval. This can also be stated as: prove that C1nt is greater than Ct upon t is greater than C1nt minus 1 in usual notations for a group replacement policy when T is the optimum period of interval. These values will have some standard notations, and with that usual notations, we can prove this for group replacement policy. Now, we prove this property, or we prove this inequality for group replacement policy. Proof. Here it is proposed to replace all the atoms at fixed interval T, whether they have failed or not, and continue the replacing failed atoms as and when they fail. With this assumption, we prepare a group replacement policy. For that policy, we have to define some usual notations. First, we have to point out these notations and their meanings. Let nt number of units failing during time t, n total number of units in the system, c of t cost of group replacement after time period t, c1 individual replacement cost on failure, c2 per unit cost of replacement in a group. This is group replacement cost and this is individual replacement cost, and this is total number of units in the system, that is n, and nt is the number of units failing during time t. Now then we have the total cost is given by ct is equals to c1 into n1 plus n2 plus so on up to n t minus 1. These are the number of atoms replaced during the period n1, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1, and that atoms are replaced by individual replacement cost c1. So we multiply the summation of these atoms by c1, and group replacement cost is c2, and there are total n atoms, so group replacement cost is c2 into n, and the total cost is this up to n individual replacements, and this group replacement cost is gives total cost as c of t, equation number 1. Hence, the average cost per unit period will be f of t is equals to ct upon t. This total cost divided by total time interval, that is t, we get average cost per unit period will be given by f of t is equals to ct upon t. Therefore, f of t is equals to c1 into n1 plus n2 up to nt minus 1 plus C2n divided by t, equation number 2. In order to determine the replacement age t, the average cost should be minimum. The condition for minimum of f of t is given by del f of t minus 1 is less than 0 is less than del f of t, equation number 3. We have to define this condition in previous group replacement policies. Here also we have to define the same conditions, same condition for minimum of average cost. Now we apply this minimum, this condition for this average cost to find out the optimum policy or group replacement policy. We have del f of t is equals to f of t plus 1 minus f of t. That is, del f of t is equals to c of t plus 1 divided by t plus 1 minus ct upon t. Now, first we have to calculate the value of c of t plus 1. As like to c of t plus 1 is equals to c1 into bracket n1 plus n2 up to nt minus 1 into nt. Nt minus 1 plus n of t plus c2n. Then we split this sum as c1 into n1 plus n2 up to nt minus 1 plus we multiply this c1 to this nt, we get c1nt, and that term we have to separate out here, and c2n as it is. Now we combine this first term c1 into n1 n2 up to nt minus 1 and plus c2n, and c1nt separated out, and this square bracket is nothing but c of t, which we have to define previously. So we get the value of c of t plus 1 is equals to c of t plus c1nt, and we put this value here in this relation. Therefore del f of t is equals to c of t plus 1 by t plus 1 minus ct upon t, which gives del f of t is equals to ct plus c1nt divided by t plus 1 minus ct upon t. Now cross multiply. Multiply this t to this total term and this t plus 1 to this c of t. We get t ct plus t c1nt minus t minus 1 into c of t. Then we multiply this. We get del f of t is equals to t into ct plus t into c1nt minus t into ct minus c of t. We multiply this c of t in this bracket and we multiply this minus sign also. We get this. In this expression, this tct and this tct gets cancelled out, and we get del f of t is equals to t c1nt minus ct divided by t into t plus 1. Now divide numerator and denominator by t. So we get del f of t is equals to c1nt minus ct upon t whole term divided by t plus 1. But del f of t must be greater than 0 for minimum of f of t. So del f of t is greater than 0. That implies c1nt minus ct upon t divided by t plus 1 is greater than 0. That implies c1nt minus ct upon t is greater than 0, and that is nothing but c1nt is greater than ct upon t. Equation number 4. Now similarly, we have del of f of t minus 1 is equals to f of t minus f of t minus 1. We put the values of f of t. So del f of t minus 1 is equals to ct upon t minus c of t minus 1 divided by t minus 1. Then again we have to find out the value of c of t minus 1. So we get c1 into n1 plus n2 up to n t minus 2 plus c2 into n. Now previously we have to we can split the summation, but here we have to add and subtract one term so that we get the total term, and for that we have to add c1 n1 t minus 1 and c1 n t minus 1. Add and subtract this term so that you can we can convert it into in the form of c of t. Then collect the term c1 into n1 plus n2 up to nt minus 1 plus c2n, and this minus c1 nt minus 1 as it is. Then this square bracket is nothing but c of t. So we get c of t minus 1 is equals to c of t minus c1 nt minus 1. Now again we put this value in this expression and simplify as per previous one. As therefore f of del f of t minus 1 is equals to ct upon t minus c of t minus 1 divided by t minus 1. Then we put the value of c of t minus 1 as ct minus c1 and t minus 1. Then cross multiply this t minus 1 multiplied by this ct and this t multiply this expression. So we get del f of t minus 1 is equals to t minus 1 into c of t minus t into c of t plus t into c1 and t minus 1. We multiply ct to this bracket. We get t into ct minus ct minus t ct plus t into c1 and t minus 1. Then t ct gets cancelled out. And just rearrange the term, we get del f of t minus 1 is equals to t c1 and t minus 1 minus c of t divided by t into t minus 1. Then divide numerator and denominator by t, we get del f of t minus 1 is equals to c1 and t minus 1 minus ct upon t divided by t minus 1. But del f of t minus 1 must be less than 0 for minimum of del f of t. So we get del f of t minus 1 is less than 0. That implies c1 and t minus 1 minus ct upon t divided by t minus 1 is less than 0. That is c1 and t minus 1 minus ct upon t is less than 0. And that is nothing but c1 and t minus 1 is less than ct upon t, equation number 5. And now we combine this equation number 4 and 5. From equations 4 and 5, we get c1 and t minus 1 is less than ct upon t is less than c1 and t. That is, this is average cost. That is, c1 and t is greater than ct upon t is greater than c1 and t minus 1, equation number 6. And thus, the group replacement policy is completely established. And that is the formula which we have to stated previously. Now, we solve one simple example corresponding to this group replacement policy. Following failure rates have been observed for a certain type of light bulbs. This is a table, week, first week, second week, third week, fourth week, fifth week, and percentage of failing at the end of the week. At the end of the week means in the first week there are 10% bulbs which are fail, and the up to second week there are 25% bulbs are failed. Then in the third week 50% bulbs are fail. In the fourth week 80% light bulbs are to be weak fail, and in the fifth week 100% light bulbs are fail. That is the term we have to given here. And there are 1000 bulbs in used. Total number of bulbs is 1000, and this is the percentage are in used, and the cost is rupees 10 to replace an individual bulbs which has burned out. Individual cost is rupees 10. If all the bulbs were replaced simultaneously, it would cost rupees 4 per bulb. Means group replacement policy, the cost of group replacement is rupees 4 and cost of individual is rupees 10. And there are total 1000 bulbs, means n is equals to capital N is equals to 1000, that we have to given. Now, it is proposed to replace all the bulbs at a fixed interval of time, whether they have burnout or not, and to continue the replacing burnout bulbs as and when they fail. At what interval all the bulbs should be replaced? At what group replacement price per bulb would a policy of strictly individual replacement becomes profitable to adopt the policy? That is the total problem. In this problem, we have to given some points and we have to use that points to solve the problem. One is total number of bulbs is 1000, cost of individual replacement cost is rupees 10, then group replacement cost is rupees 4 per bulb. These terms we have to given, and also we have to given the probability of failure in each week, up to that week. Let PI be the probability that a light bulb which has new when placed in the position for use fails during the ith week of its life. Thus, the following frequency distribution is obtained assuming to replace burnout bulbs as and when they fail. That means first we have to find out the corresponding probabilities. P1 is the probability of failure in the first week. Total it is 10% in the first week. 10% means 10 divided by 100, that is equals to 0.1. probability of failure in the first week is 0.1. P2, the probability of failure in the second week. Up to second week there are 20%, 25% will be fail, and in the first week there are 10% will be fail. So the failure probability of failure in the second week will be 25 minus 10 divided by 100, that is 0.15. That is, the probability of the second week is 0.15. Similarly, for P3, that is probability of failure in the third week is 50 minus 25 divided by 100. Up to third week there are 50% will be fail, and up to second week there are 25% fail. So the probability in the failure in the third week is 50 minus 25 divided by 100, that is 0.25. Similarly, P4, probability of failure in fourth week is 80 minus 50 divided by 100 is equals to 0.3. And similar to that, P5, probability of failure in the fifth week is equals to 100 minus 80 divided by 100 is equals to 0.2. These are the probabilities which we have to use in the calculations, and for that these probabilities are to be required. If possible, please pause the video and just note down these just probabilities, so that the future further calculations to be clear out. Now, since the sum of probability is 1, if we add all these probabilities is equals to 1, therefore all further probabilities will be 0. All further probabilities will be 0. Means P6, 6th week's probability will be 0, 7th week's probability is 0. Therefore P6, P7, P8, all the probabilities will be 0. Thus the bulb that has already lasted first 4 week is sure to fail during the 5th week. The bulb has already lasted 4 week is sure to fail in the 5th week. Means in the 5th week, the first assume that bulbs are failed during a week are replaced just before the end of that week. And the actual percentage of failure during a week for a subpopulation of bulbs with the same age is the same as the expected percentage of failure the week for that population, for that subpopulation. Let Ni be the number of replacement mode at the end of ith week. Let all 1000 bulbs are new initially. So N0 is equals to 1000. Now we calculate the number of bulbs failure in first week, that is N1. How to calculate? They are in 0.1%. Probability is 0.1. So we multiply this N0 by P1. We get 1000 into 0.1, so it gives 100. Means in the first week we have to replace in all 1000 bulbs there are 100 bulbs which are failed, and in that week we have to replace these 100 bulbs newly. So we come to the next for N2, means in the second week. In the second week, the total of 1000 bulbs, 0.15% will be failed, and in the first week we have to newly added 100 bulbs, and in that newly added 100 bulbs, 10% will be failed. So total number of bulbs failing in the second week is given by N0 into P2 plus N1 into P1. So it is 1000 into 0.15 and 100 into 0.1. Means in all, so total it will be 160. Just numerical calculation, you can calculate yourself. Then come to the third week. In the third week, the total bulbs, original total 1000 bulbs of 25% will be failed. And then newly we add 100 bulbs in the second week. In the first week, they completed 2 weeks. So they fail in these 1000. There are 15% bulbs will be failed. And newly added 160 bulbs in the second week, out of that 10% bulbs will be also fail. Hence the total number of fails in third week is 281. This is the calculations, just numerically calculate. On the similar way, we can calculate the number of fails in N4, that is N0 into P4, N1 into P3, N2 into P2 and N3 into P1. Original 1000, out of original 1000, only 0.3% will be failed. Out of first week's new 100 bulbs, 25% will be failed. Out of newly added 160 bulbs in the second week, there are 0.15 bulbs will be fail. And out of the new third week bulbs, that is 281, 10% will be fail. So it will be the total calculation will be 377. Here it is 281, not 283. Just a printing mistake. Then on the same way, we can calculate for N5, it gives 350. Then N6, we get 230. N7 up to 286. Now, if we observe all these, here we starts, it is increasing up to 377. Then it starts again decreasing for some extent. And then again it starts increasing. We have to know these numbers N1, N2, N3, N4, N5, N6 for further calculations. If possible, please pause the video and point out these numbers so that further calculations to be clear out. This is numerical calculation, you can calculate yourself also. One more point I will mention here. Please check this. This is 281 or 283. If it is 283 or 281, just one printing mistake, just make your calculations and point out the correct answer. It is clear that the expected number of bulbs burn out in each week increases until the fourth week and decreases until the sixth week again and starts increasing. Thus, the number will continue to oscillate and ultimately the system settle down in a steady state in which the promotional bulbs for failing in each week is reciprocal of their average life. Since the mean age of the bulb is 1 into P1, 2 into P2, 3 into P3, 4 into P4 and 5 into P5. Just calculate these numerical calculations, we get 3.35 weeks, that is mean age of the bulbs. We calculate each number of week to the corresponding probability. Up to 5 weeks, the bulb will be burned. So to find the mean, we have to calculate the mean age of the bulb by using this calculation. It will be 3.35 weeks. Now, the number of failures in each week in a steady state becomes equals to 1000 divided by mean age of bulb. So 1000 divided by 3.35, it gives 298.50, that is 299 approximately. Means approximately 299 bulbs will be fail in each week in a steady state. And the cost of replacing individually only and failure at the rate of rupees 10 per bulb. Total 299 bulbs, one bulb will be replaced by rupees 10. Therefore, the average individual replacement cost is rupees 2990. Since the replacement of all bulbs, all 1000 bulbs simultaneously cost is rupees 4 per bulb, and the replacement of individual bulb cost is rupees 10 per bulb. Therefore, the cost of replacement of all bulbs simultaneously is given as follows. We have one calculation table. As first end of week, cost of individual replacement, total cost of group replacement, and average cost per week. So, first cost of individual replacement. In the first week, there are 100 bulbs are to be filled. Each bulb cost is 10 rupees. Therefore, cost of individual replacement in first week is 1000. The total cost of group replacement is first 1000 bulb will be replaced by rupees group by group replacement. Each bulb by rupees 4. Therefore, it will be 1000 into 4 plus this individual replacement cost, that is 1000. The total cost for group replacement in the first week is 5000. Average cost is also again 5000. Come to the second week. In the second week, N2 is 160. Bulbs will be fail. Therefore, their cost of individual replacement is 1600. We add this individual cost to this group replacement cost. So we get the total cost of group replacement up to the second week, that is 5000 plus 1600, it gives 6600. To find its average cost, we have to divide it by 2, because it up to second week cost, it will be 3300. Now come to the third week. In the third week, number of atoms will be failed, it is 281. So total group individual replacement cost is 2810, and total cost of group replacement up to third week is we add this 2810 to this 6660, we get total 9410. To find average cost, we have to divide it by 3, we get 3136. Then in the fourth week, the there are 377 atoms will be failed. Therefore, their cost of individual replacement is 3770. We add this to find the total cost of group replacement up to fourth week. We get 13180. And to find the average cost, we have to divide it by 4. So we get 3295. Now, if we observe this last two average cost, obviously this cost starts increasing from fourth year. Also observe that this average cost 3136 is in between 2810 and 3770. So we replace this group replace these light bulbs at the end of the third week. That will be the concluding remark corresponding to this example. The cost of individual replacement in the fourth week exceeds the cost of the third week, that is 3136 is less than 3770. Thus, it would be optimum to replace all the bulbs after every 3 weeks, otherwise the average cost starts increasing. These are the reference books corresponding to all these lectures. We have to take all the theory and problem points corresponding using these reference books. If you want some more points corresponding to this part, you can refer these books also. Thank you for watching this video. If you like video, please share and subscribe my channel Mathematics with Sachin for such an interesting lectures corresponding to the operation research and also corresponding on the mathematics. Thank you once again.